गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा, लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर इंट्रोडक्शन टू यूक्लिड ज्योमेट्री. फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज वी हैड कंप्लीटेड. नाउ लुक एट द एग्जांपल नंबर 3 ऑन पेज नंबर 87. कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट. देयर एग्जिस्ट अ पेयर ऑफ स्ट्रेट लाइंस दैट आर एवरीवेयर इक्विडिस्टेंट फ्रॉम वन अनदर. व्हाट डज इट मीन? इफ यू ड्रॉ टू लाइंस and the distance between the two lines is same everywhere, what does it mean? That these two given lines are parallel. Kehte, is this statement the direct consequence of the Euclid fifth postulate? What is explained in the Euclid fifth postulate? It says that if the two lines are not parallel, then the sum of the angles on the one side where these two lines will intersect each other at the one corner and the sum of the angles is always less than 180. If the lines are parallel, then the sum of the angles is 180, and if the lines are not parallel, nothing is given about the lines. But this thing is given that when you draw two lines and there is a transversal, and when you will produce these two lines, they will intersect somewhere. So definitely the sum of these two angles will be less than 180 degrees. इसका मतलब ये है कि अगर दो एंगल्स का सम लेस देन 180 है, दैट मींस द लाइंस आर नॉट पैरेलल, दे विल डेफिनेटली इंटरसेक्ट समवेयर व्हेन इट विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड. बट इफ द टू लाइंस आर पैरेलल, देन दे विल नॉट मेक एंगल द सम ऑफ कोइंटीरियर एंगल एज लेस देन 180, दे विल श्योरली मेक द सम एज 180 डिग्री. तो इस एग्जांपल में आपको ये कह रहा है कि आपने ये बताना है कि ये जो ये स्टेटमेंट गिवन है कि दो लाइंस का जो इक्वल डिस्टेंस है दो लाइंस के बीच में, दे विल बी ऑलवेज सेम. तो अगर दो लाइंस के बीच का डिस्टेंस सेम है, आप लिखोगे इफ द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू लाइंस इज ऑलवेज सेम, दैट मींस द लाइन मस्ट बी पैरेलल. एंड देन यू विल एक्सप्लेन द यूक्लिड फिफ्थ पोस्टुलेट. फिफ्थ पोस्टुलेट में जो स्टेटमेंट है वो लिख दोगे. इसमें लिखा हुआ है टेक अ लाइन एल एंड अ पॉइंट पी not on L, then by Playfair axiom, which is the equivalent to fifth postulate, we know that there is a unique line M passing through P which is parallel to L. तो आपने सीधा बताना है कि L और M two lines हैं. You will not write this result, that is answer. You will write the answer in your own language. There two lines are there and there is a transversal, then sum of these two angles will be equal to 180 and the distance between two lines are same, that means the lines must be parallel. And this result follows from the fifth postulate, then you will write the statement of the fifth postulate. That's it. Okay? लिखा हुआ है. Now the distance of a point from a line is the length of perpendicular. तो कहते हैं ये जो सारे distance आएंगे, they all are perpendicular distance. You will write it in your own language. No need to cram this language. You please write in your own words. ठीक है, एक चीज और बताने की आपको. थ्योरम नंबर 5.1 दैट इज गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 85, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई थिंक 2-3 इयर्स बैक दिस क्वेश्चन वाज देयर इन द एग्जाम. इधर सुनो, आपको क्या कहता है? टू डिस्टिंक्ट लाइंस कैन नॉट हैव मोर देन वन पॉइंट इन कॉमन. कहता है टू लाइंस है, जब वो इंटरसेक्ट करती हैं तो वो एक पॉइंट पे करती हैं. ठीक है, ये आपको पता है. लेकिन आपने ये शो करना है मैथमेटिकली कि ये रिजल्ट जो है वो ट्रू है. हम सपोज कर लेते हैं कि L और M दो लाइंस हैं, ये एक पॉइंट ऑफ इंटरसेक्शन की बजाय टू पॉइंट्स पे कट कर रही है. अगर अब ये देखो, आप यहाँ पे लिखा हुआ है, ये सब आप रीड कर सकते हो. हम ये ड्रॉ नहीं करेंगे, क्योंकि अगर हम ड्रॉ करते हैं तो यहाँ से ये विजिबल है कि टू लाइंस जो है वो वन पॉइंट पे इंटरसेक्ट करती है. लेकिन हम ये मैथमेटिकली प्रूव करने जा रहे हैं, तो हम क्या करेंगे, हम सपोज कर लेंगे कि टू लाइंस जो हैं L एंड M इंटरसेक्ट एट टू पॉइंट्स P एंड Q. ठीक है, हमने सपोज कर लिया कि दो लाइंस जो हैं वो टू पॉइंट्स पे इंटरसेक्ट करती है. अब आपको ये पता है कि अगर दो लाइंस दो पॉइंट है, आपको ये भी पता है, ये रिजल्ट है आपका, कि किसी भी दो पॉइंट से एक ही लाइन पास होती है. लेकिन हम तो यहाँ ये कह रहे हैं कि L और M टू लाइंस हैं जो टू पॉइंट्स पे कट कर रही है, मतलब टू पॉइंट से पास कर रही है. लेकिन हमारे पास एक रिजल्ट है कि टू देयर इज ओनली वन लाइन पासिंग थ्रू टू पॉइंट्स. तो इसका मतलब इस रिजल्ट से हम ये कह सकते हैं कि जो हमने सपोज किया है वो गलत है. इसका मतलब कि जो टू लाइंस है दे विल नेवर इंटरसेक्ट एट टू पॉइंट, दे विल श्योरली इंटरसेक्ट एट वन पॉइंट. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू रीड द सॉल्यूशन दैट इज गिवन इन योर बुक. हियर आर द टू लाइंस एल एंड एम, वी नीड टू प्रूव दैट दे विल इंटरसेक्ट एट वन पॉइंट. वी वॉन्ट टू प्रूव दिस. सो फॉर दिस लेट अस सपोज दैट द टू लाइन इंटरसेक्ट एट टू पॉइंट पी एंड क्यू. You have two lines passing through two distinct points. Two lines, two distinct points से pass कर रही है. But this clashes with the assumption that the axiom that only one line passes through two distinct points. आप ये result लिखोगे कि दो points से सिर्फ एक ही line pass करती है. So our assumption is wrong. Two lines cannot intersect at two point. They will surely intersect at one point. Got it? Any doubt? So what you will do is you will write here L and M are two lines. We want to prove that two lines intersect at one point. Now solution will start. You will write let L and M. If you want to write the solution, I can write this for you. You please note down this solution in the FAIR notebook. Write this today. In today's homework, you will do theorem number 5.1. Solution I am writing here. आपको क्या गिवन है? L एंड M आर टू लाइन्स. वॉट वी वॉन्ट टू प्रूव इज L एंड M इंटरसेक्ट एट वन पॉइंट. दिस वी वॉन्ट टू शो दैट दे विल इंटरसेक्ट एट वन पॉइंट. ओके, दिस वी वॉन्ट टू शो. Now in the solution, what you will do is, solution में आप क्या करोगे? Let us suppose that L and M intersect at two points. Let us suppose that L and M intersect at two points. ये आपने सपोज कर लिया. दैट इज पी एंड क्यू. बाय द एक्सियम आई एम राइटिंग द रिजल्ट. वन एंड only one line passes through two distinct points. This implies it clashes with our assumption. It clashes with our assumption that two lines intersect at two points. This implies L and M has only one point of intersection. Is it okay? So this is all about this theorem number 5.1. So you please all note it down. This you will write in your FAIR notebook. Now after this we will start the exercise 5.2. Only two questions are there. So let's start with these two questions. Note down these are here. This question you will do in the FAIR notebook. And from exercise 5.2, question number 2 is your homework. This question is a part of your homework, and from exercise 5.2, question number 2 is your homework. Now, in exercise 5.1, first question is, how would you rewrite Euclid's fifth postulate so that it would be easier to understand? You have to write the easiest way of the fifth postulate. तो अभी हमने बताया कि fifth postulate आपको क्या कहता है कि अगर two lines parallel हैं तो sum of the co-interior angle must be 180 degree and if the sum of the two lines are not parallel then the sum of the angles is on the one side of the transversal is less than 180. ठीक है, तो हमने यही शो करना है यहाँ पर कि जो दो एंगल यहाँ पे इजी वे में आपने स्टेटमेंट को लिखना है तो आप लिखोगे टू लाइंस आर सेट टू बी पैरेलल ये इजीएस्ट वे टू लर्न फिफ्थ पोस्टुलेट आप लर्न कर सकते हो टू लाइंस आर सेट टू बी parallel if they are equidistant from one another this is same as your example number 3 that we have just discussed in the today's class in the beginning of the today's class Two lines are said to be parallel if they are equidistant from one another and they do not have a point of intersection means they do not intersect they do not have a point of intersection okay So this is all about the easiest way to write the fifth postulate. Question number 2 is, does Euclid fifth postulate implies the existence of parallel lines? ये वो भी same ही है, लेकिन थोड़ा सा लिखने का way अलग है. Yes, write down. Yes, Euclid fifth postulate. Yes, according to Euclid's fifth postulate, when line n fall on the line l and m such that this is the exact statement that you have learned in the fifth postulate so you have to learn it such that angle 1 plus angle 2 is less than 180 and you will draw this figure 1 2 l this is your n this is your m theek hai ye aap draw karoge isme l m and the line is n then line l and m then line l and m will meet each other when produced in the side of angle 1 एंड एंगल टू मीन्स एंगल वन और टू की साइड पे जब इनको प्रोड्यूस किया जाएगा दे विल श्योरली इंटरसेक्ट एट सम पॉइंट. ओके which is angle 1 plus angle 2 which is less than 180 degree. This you have to learn beta. अब आपसे पूछ रहा है कि अब आपको यहाँ पे ये भी बताना है कि parallel line की existence show करता है कि नहीं, तो आप ये लिखोगे. तो according to this if the sum of the angles is 180 that means they will not meet each other, the lines must be parallel. यहाँ पे finish हो गया. We find that the lines which are not according to fifth postulate, the lines which are not according to fifth postulate, that is angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 will not meet each other. The lines which are not according to the fifth postulate, they will surely have some as 180 degree and they will not meet each other. But agar fifth postulate ke according hai, then lines will surely meet each other at one point in the direction of angle 1 and angle 2. But if the lines are not according to fifth postulate, that means the lines must be parallel and they will make the sum as sum of two angles as 180 degree. Beta, with this we had completed our chapter number 5, introduction to Euclid. Now let's start with the chapter number 7, that is your triangles. As you have must have learned about the term triangles in the 7th class, congruency chapter we had done there also, if you remember. So this chapter is in relation to that chapter number, chapter triangles that we had discussed in the class 7. So same concepts are there. So we are going to start with this chapter and introduction we will discuss first. Yes, in triangles, two terms are there. First concept is similar and the another concept is congruent. What is the difference between these two? सिमिलर जैसे मैं आपको कहूं मैंने एक सर्कल ड्रॉ किया, एक बड़ा सर्कल ड्रॉ किया, है तो दोनों ही सर्कल ही, दे आर सिमिलर इन शेप. सिमिलैरिटी मीन्स सेम इन शेप. और कॉन्ग्रेंसी का मतलब होता है सेम शेप एंड सेम size also matters here, but in similarity the shape is only same. जैसे आपको आपके कोई आपको कहता है कि आपका फेस आपके पेरेंट्स के जैसा सिमिलर, आपके मम्मा के जैसे, आपके पापा के जैसे, तो सिमिलर का मतलब है देखने में फीचर सेम है, मेजरमेंट तो नहीं सेम ना, तो सिमिलैरिटी दैट इज कॉल्ड सिमिलैरिटी. कॉन्ग्रेंट मीन्स द शेप एंड द साइज बोथ आर सेम. सो दैट्स द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सिमिलैरिटी एंड कॉन्ग्रुएंस. Now, next is two circles are congruent if their radii are same. अगर दो circle है दोनों का radius same है, that means their size must be same. सिमिलर तो है ही है क्योंकि शेप सेम है, लेकिन साइज भी सेम है, दैट इज दैट्स व्हाई दीज टू सर्कल्स आर सेड टू बी कॉन्कर्ड. नेक्स्ट इज टू रेक्टेंगल्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट इफ दे हैव सेम लेंथ एंड ब्रेथ. If they have same length and same breadth, two line segment are congruent if they have same length. Two line segments है जिनकी length 3-3 है तो दोनों क्या होंगी congruent क्योंकि इनकी length same. Write down these concepts here. Few more concepts are there. Yes, Tiksha.
Ma'am, girls.
Okay. Two squares are congruent if their sides are same. Two angles are congruent if their measurements are same. Got it? Any doubt? Now, let's discuss about the congruency of triangles. Two triangles are congruent if they follow any of the following five rules. If any one rule is applicable, that means the triangles are congruent. Two triangles are congruent. This all things you will write in the field. Two triangles are congruent if they satisfy one of these. Number one is SSS, number two is SAS, number three is ASA, number four is AAS, and number five is RHS. What are these? These are the congruency rules. Triple S means side, side, side criteria, side angle, side criteria, angle, side angle, 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 side, right hand, right hypotenuse side. Any side you can take. If they satisfy one of these congruency criteria, if they satisfy one of these congruency criteria, so these are the five criteria that we will discuss. First criteria is given in your book on page number 125. On page number 125, first criteria is given. Yes, I am explaining the first criteria, that is triple S. If two triangles ABC and DEF are there, if their corresponding side AB is equal to DE, BC is equal to EF, and this third side AC is equal to DF, then we can say that two triangles ABC and DEF are congruent by triple S, side, side, side. So if you want to draw the figure, you can draw. Otherwise, you can just directly write this result that is given on page number 125. If the three sides of the one triangle are equal to the three sides of the another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. If three sides of the one triangle are equal to the corresponding three sides of the other triangle, then the triangles are said to be congruent. No need to do this. You will write this statement as a first part in your notebook on page number 125. It is given. Don't do this. This is just for the explanation. You will write this statement. You will write these 6 points. Then you will explain each one by one from your book. What happened in this second rule? If the two sides, side, side, and included angle. Included angle means the angle included between these two equal sides are given. So AB is equal to DF, BC is equal to EF, and one more thing will be added here, that is angle B is equal to angle P. So this will become side angle side. It's compulsory to have angle included between the equal sides. Okay? Is it okay? So this is your second rule and it is given on your page number 113. Two triangles are congruent if the two sides and the included angle of the triangle is equal to the two sides and included angle of the another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent by SAS. So you will write first and second rule. This is from page number 125 and this is from 113 page number. You will write the statement from there. Okay.